بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. These questions one of the common questions in the Arab port, Saudi port, Jordanian port and Egyptian port. We'll see our question here. This is mother deliver a new unit with meconium staining. Once you hear it meconium, interpret this word by asphyxia, BPHN and pneumothorax. Asphyxia, BPHN and pneumothorax. We'll continue our question here. And Apgar score of 3 at 1 and 5 minutes of life. Apgar score is low, again interpreted with asphyxia. Asphyxia. She has no perinatal care and the delivery was by emergency cesarean sections for severe fetal bradycardia. Again, fetal bradycardia. Again, put in your mind, this is asphyxia. Asphyxia and multi-organ dysfunction. Asphyxia, it's associated with BPHN and actually if there is meconium, asphyxia and pneumothorax or air leak, air leaks. Which of the following sequelae could be expected to develop in this intubate? You see the baby intubated also. Intubated neonate with respiratory distress. With respiratory distress. So this patient having meconium, low Apgar score, cesarean due to bradycardia, baby intubated due to respiratory stress. This indicate all this actually asphyxia, BPHN and pneumothorax. Asphyxia, BPHN and pneumothorax. Put in your mind all of this before you look for the items of the question. A, sustained rise in the pulmonary arterial pressure. Yes, for sure. We said asphyxia, it will be associated with multi-organ dysfunction. And one of the complications of the asphyxia, it will be BPHN and meconium. It will be complicated with pneumothorax also. Hyperactive bowel sound is not. Microcephaly and micrognathia. Actually, the baby is not dysmorphic. Cataract and thrombocytosis. So the answer here, it will be sustained rise in the pulmonary arterial pressure. Why? Once you hear it meconium, this interpret this meconium by asphyxia and BPHN. Asphyxia and BPHN. And put in your mind, meconium, it will be associated with air leak or pneumothorax or pneumomediastinum. So this is the meconium. Meconium, what is the complication of the meconium? If the depend on the particles. If large particles, it will block the airway. Maybe it will collapse and will die immediately. Or the particle, it will be small. It will make it lead to collapse of the lung. Or it will be small, leading to pool valve mechanism. Pool valve mechanism, it may lead to air trapping or air leak. Air leak, it will be associated with hypoxia, acidosis, hypercapnia, and for sure, primary pulmonary hypertension. Primary pulmonary BPHN. BPHN. Later on, the baby can lead to also chemical pneumonitis or pneumonia, chemical pneumonitis, and leading to atelectasis. And surfactant in activations lead to atelectasis. Atelectasis leading to intrapulmonary shunting. Intrapulmonary shunting and right to left shunt. Right to left shunt through the BDA or foramen ovale and leading to BPHN. BPHN. So what is the complication of the meconium? Depend on the particle. Particle is large and maybe it will lead to collapse of the lung or it will be small leading to bowel valve mechanism. If it goes to the distal, if in the proximal bronchiole lead to collapse, or it will go to the distal bronchiole lead to pool valve mechanism, lead to air leak. Air leak lead to hypoxia, acidosis and BPHN. Also it lead to chemical pneumonitis and will inactivate the surfactant, lead to atelectasis, intrapulmonary shunting, and lead to hypoxia and acidosis and vicious circle and BPHN. So put in your mind, meconium aspiration syndrome, the complication ABCD. A, asphyxia, asphyxia, acidosis, and P, PBHN, PBHN, pneumothorax, pneumomediastinum, and C, collapse, and chemical pneumonitis, and chemical D, it might lead to death, it may lead to death. If you see here, this is the X-ray of the meconium, it will be actually associated, this is with, it will be diffuse coarse infiltration, diffuse coarse infiltration. This is the classic picture of the meconium aspirations, and here it will be complicated with pneumothorax, pneumothorax, left tension pneumothorax. And also this is the X-ray, it will be associated with all complication of meconium aspiration. This is air trapping and hyperexpansion from the airway obstruction. infection. This is acute atelectasis, and this is pneumomediastinum from gas trapping and air leaks and diffuse chemical pneumonitis with constituent of the meconium. And here you see left pneumothorax with depressed diaphragm and minimal mediastinal shift because of non-compliant lung. So this patient having low Apgar score, meconium stain, respiratory stress, intubated, suggests what? Asphyxia. قولا واحدا. Meconium, it will be asphyxia. Asphyxia lead to hypoxia, hypercapnia, and acidosis. It will leading to BPHN and pneumothorax and collapsing lung due to an activation of the surfactant may lead to death. May lead to death or multi-organ dysfunction. During the period of the asphyxia, what is the sequence of the asphyxia or result of hypoxia, hypercapnia, acidosis, and poor perfusion can damage of the neonate brain and lead to acute kidney injury, acute tubular necrosis, and liver injuries, and DIC, and also it lead to chemical pneumonitis or pneumothorax or pneumomediastinum. So the result clinical abnormalities from this asphyxia lead to cerebral edema, CNS abnormalities, it will be irritability, seizure, cardiomegaly, and heart failure, renal failure, poor liver function, and DIC and respiratory stress syndrome. There can be exacerbated with high BPHN, pulmonary arterial pressure. It will be high. You have pulmonary vascular resistance and systemic vascular resistance. Pulmonary vascular resistance, it will be higher, and systemic vascular resistance, it will fall and also lead to right to left shunt through the foramen ovale or BDE or BDA. So it will exacerbated with high arterial pressure, pulmonary arterial pressure. At the same time, systemic blood pressure, it will bring to fall down, resulting in resistant right to left shunting across the BDA and foramen ovale. So once you hear it, meconium, put in your mind, asphyxia. Asphyxia is means hypoxia, hypercapnia, and acidosis is leading to PPHN and air leaks and lung collapse due to inactivation of the surfactant, or it's due to the particles it goes to the proximal bronchioles, it will block it, lead to collapse, or to distal bronchioles, it's lead to air valve mechanism, it's called bull valve mechanism, lead to air trapping and pneumothorax. Pneumothorax it leading to air leaks, lead to hypoxia, acidosis, and BPHN and vicious circle. ومن أحيا فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا. سلام عليكم.